Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com is my website. I used to write step-by-step articles on SAP basis administration in this website. I am Mr. Raz, SAP basis international trainer. I have trained students in 55 countries. In this video, I am going to explain how to configure multi-system landscape. This is my server where I have installed 4 SAP systems in single host. Between development, quality and production, I have already configured 3 system landscape. I have shown how to configure 3 system landscape in my earlier video. So now I am going to add this 4th system to existing system so that it will become multi-system landscape. Actually, SAP recommends to use 3 system landscape, that is development, quality and production. But for testing purpose or training purpose, you can have additional systems also, so that multi-system landscape configuration is also important. So let us see how to configure multi-system landscape. First of all, just to check what is the system landscape is already been configured, we can log on to development system and check it up. Just double click on this entry to log on to the development system. Use 000 client. Here STMST code, hit enter. So this is the initial screen of TMS. Go to overview, click on the system so that it will show all the systems available in this configuration. And you can click on environment and click on the transport routes to see the landscape. So this is the landscape: development system, quality and production, 3 system landscape. Now I am going to show how to add 4th system. Go back from here and just add a virtual system here. Click on the virtual system. And which system I am going to add, that is the DIS system, so that you can use DIS here. System DIS. Click on the save. And should configuration change be distributed immediately, means the configuration change will be distributed to other systems which are already configured in the landscape, that is quality and production. So this information will be intimated to those systems also. Click on S button here to intimate immediately. So here 4 systems are there, and DIS system is denoting this symbol as virtual system, and you can view the same information from other systems also, that is by logging on to QAS or production. Just log on to the QAS and production to view the same information in those systems also, because the configuration change already been transferred. STMS or your systems, and in the production also. So while I am doing any experiment in these screens, just to observe this part so that you will be understand what system we are logging in, that is PRD system, and it is QAS system 000 client. This is DEV system 000 client. Okay, so go to PRD here and enter STMS, hit enter and click on the overview, click on the systems. So the virtual system has been added here also, that means the information is displaying here also. And if you click on environment and click on transport routes, what it will show? Existing three system landscape will show, and the DAS system is ready for configuring. And you see in the QAS system also, click on the environment, click on the transport routes. See, three system landscape and DAS system is here. But to configure the DAS system as fourth system here, so you should have the display and change button. Where this display and change button will be available? Only in the domain controller. Only in the domain controllers. So that, switch to domain controller and go to environment and click on the transport routes. From here you can configure the fourth system into this landscape, so that it will become multi-system landscape. In this way you can add any number of systems to existing landscape. Just click on the display or change button here, and the configuration editor switch to change mode. Now click on this disk system here and click anywhere in the open space, so that the disk system will come here. Okay, once you place this DAS system here, click on this add transport route button and select QAS system and hold the mouse button, drag it to DAS system. I want to create delivery route between QAS system to DAS system. So select the delivery route from here, that is QAS system to DAS system. This route is called consolidation route, this is route is called delivery route. Okay, so just click on the transfer button so that the route will be created between these two systems. So in this way you can create any number of routes, like you can create any number of SAP systems, and you can create the routes, whichever the route you want. Okay, now once you create this route, click on the save button and name this landscape as multi system landscape. Okay, click on the save button. Do you want to distribute and activate the configuration across all systems? Yes. So that the configuration will be distributed to all the systems. So configuration was distributed and activated. Okay, just let us look at QAS system, what is the status. Click on the refresh button here so that the DAS system is there here, and in the same way PRD system also, click on the refresh button so that the same graphic will be displayed here. That means the configuration is distributed to all the systems in the landscape. Now the DAS system, still it is virtual system, so that you, if you want to convert this DAS system as a physical system, just you can do that from DAS system only, because the virtual system should be changed to physical system. That means you have to log on to the DAS system first, then you have to configure the TMS in that particular system. So 000 again here, DDIC, STMS. And the domain controller is named DEV, target host is this, that is domain controller name is DEV. That means it is, this particular system is adding into the within that domain, that is transport domain is domain_dev. Okay, click on the save button here. So new system is being added to the existing landscape. The SAP system waiting to be included in the transport domain. You have to approve this particular system in the domain controller. Where is the domain controller? DEV. Now you just click on the refresh button so that this virtual symbol will be disappeared. You see the virtual system is disappeared and the symbol from the status symbol is changed to waiting to be included. Just select this system and click on the SAP system, click on the approve button and click on the yes button here. And should configuration change be distributed immediately? Yes, the configuration will be distributed to all the systems within the landscape immediately. Just let us look at the information here. Just go to exit here in the QAS system, click on the refresh button. So see, this is active and the DIS system became physical system. In the same way, production, go to configuration, click on the exit button, click on the refresh so that it is changed to active. Okay, DIS system is active. And in the same way, the DIS system, within the DIS system also click on the systems. So same information should be displayed here. Yes, the DIS system is active and all other systems are also active. Click on the environment, click on the transport route so that the same graphic should be visible here like this. Okay, in this way, if you want to add another system, you can add by clicking on the SAP system from here, SAP system, create, and click on the virtual system. So either way, you can create virtual system, then you can convert this virtual system as physical system, or you can add directly the physical system. How you can add directly the physical system? You should have the physical system, you should log on to the system. There you have to configure STMS, that is transport management system. When you get that display, that domain controller communication system, you need to accept all the defaults and click on the save button so that the physical system will be added to the existing landscape. And once it is added, you have to create the transport route between whatever the route, like consolidation or delivery route. So this is the concept of creating like configuring multi-system landscape. I hope you understood about all types of landscapes in these videos. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or doubts, you can leave your comments in my website, that is www.punarvasi.com, or also you can leave your comments in my YouTube channel, that is within this under this video. And if you want to buy all the videos which are recorded by me, you can go to my website, that is punarvasi.com. You can click on the SAP basis page. There the PayPal button is available. You can buy. Thanks for watching.